Welcome back, everybody. Thank you guys so much for stopping by. Hope you guys are having a good one out there today. Guys, I'm gonna be telling you how to get bot lobbies, and I'm gonna tell you the ins and outs of bot lobbies as well. If you guys could, make sure to drop a sub, use my code COBESMIND. If we end up hitting 10,000 supporters, I'll do a 100-hour live stream on my YouTube of grinding out XP. And I feel like that's a perfect segue into what bot lobbies are and how to get them. So if you guys don't know anything about bot lobbies, if you go into a regular game right now, if you just started playing, your first couple games will actually be in bot lobbies. If you just started playing, you'll be in bot lobbies until you hit level 10, and then you're going to be thrown into real lobbies against actual players. And typically when anybody in the Fortnite community says bots, they're typically talking about bad players. But for me, I'm talking about Fortnite created AI, not real human beings, just computers. So when you hop into a bot lobby game, you basically own the lobby. Unless you're as bad as an actual AI, then I guess you don't. You're on even playing field. But the first thing I wanted to mention, with the whole Epic and Apple debacle, we obviously will not be able to play bot lobbies on any Apple device. That's including phones, computers, or anything else Apple. You still can play on Apple devices, but you'll be stuck in Chapter 2 Season 3, and you can't play with anyone outside of someone else on an Apple device. Now with that out of the way, literally any other device you can possibly play Fortnite on, literally you could play on a 1992 computer if it runs Fortnite. Anything else works as a potential partner for bot lobbies. For instance, I use Nintendo Switch. And I'll be bringing up secondary account because that's what I consider it. It's my second account, which I use bot lobbies on. And I used to use my iPhone, but obviously we can't use that as of right now. But you can use any phone outside of Apple, whether that be Samsung, well, that's really all I know, or anything else. PlayStation, Xbox, PC, or anything else I'm forgetting. It literally doesn't matter what device you're on, as long as you're using a second device. You will have to make a brand new Fortnite account that hasn't been played on for a single game ever before. There are some rules you want to follow so you won't be banned by Epic Games. Now listen up, because this is important. And one quick side note, guys, you will still be able to play on your main account, but the bot lobby account will have to be a brand new one. If you have an older account that, let's say, is from season 9 of chapter 1, and you used to play on that account, or you've ever played on that account, but this season it's level 1, that will not work. It will place you in potentially bad lobbies, but you will actually be playing against players, not bots. So for anyone with an account like that, make sure to make a brand new one. And once that's all done, log in with your second device that you want to not really play on. You're going to be playing on your main device, whatever that is, and invite your main account to your lobby from your secondary account that's level 1, that's brand new. Then once that's all done, it's pretty self-explanatory. You will be able to play regular duos, trios, or squads with your secondary account as the host. You can't play Team Rumble, arenas, or LTMs and get bot lobbies. Don't do it. I've tried it. It's a waste of time. Trust me, guys. If I could play Team Rumble, I would play that all day with bots. I would. If I could play some of these LTMs with bots, again, I would, but you can't. So once you load into a game, you will want to back out with your secondary account, but only after the Battle Bus symbol pops up. So anyone who left the video before this is going to have to wait a couple extra minutes to load into the game. I don't know exactly why, but it does happen. I feel like it's Epic Games' system trying to figure out, should we put this person in bot lobbies because your bot account isn't in there? Yes, it will eventually put you into a bot lobby, but it's gonna take so long. So guys, make sure to wait for that Battle Bus symbol, the countdown starting from 15 or 10, and then once it starts to count down, then you can back out with your secondary account. If you don't back out once you see the Battle Bus countdown and your bot stays in the game, that means your second account will eventually level up. When your second account hits level 10, you will not be able to get into bot lobbies anymore. But at that point, you can just make another account and start up bot lobbies again. I think a very important note I must touch on before we move on, bot lobbies are not against Epic's TOS or Terms of Service. You can play bot lobbies because you're not affecting anybody but yourself. And of course, the AI creations by Epic Games. That's why it's so important and why I'm trying to hammer home to stay below level 10 and to make a new second account if you ever have played on it before. Because once your second account hits level 10, you'll be placed in real lobbies against real players, but they'll be just very, very bad. So Epic may end up banning you for taking advantage and basically bullying new players, which Epic will always take very seriously. And guys, I would say it's just not ethically right to just go into very bad lobbies on purpose against real players just to destroy them for your own self-gain. It's just not right. We don't want to run off new players, and that's actually part of it. We're taking ourselves out of the equation. If you're an amazing player, you're taking yourself out of regular lobbies and throwing yourself into bot lobbies. Something else that's sort of important, guys, how to tell you are in bot lobbies if you don't know. Bot players rarely build, and if they do, it's only a wall or a stair. They cannot build above one wall high, so if you see that happen, you're not in bot lobbies. Back out and figure out what's wrong. Bots will never land at the spire because the AI Spire Guardian is there. Same with any other Spire Guardian unnamed location, but they can land at locations with Fortnite NPCs. I believe they will run into the spire if necessary, but they will never land there. Another thing you may notice, you will always be able to get the first medal for almost everything, such as talking to a Fortnite character or fishing. Bots won't do those things, but they will open up chests, so you won't be able to get the first medal on that every game. Bots do also have a weird movement and can do 180 turns at random and hit you hard, so definitely watch out. And just because bots are hitting shots on you does not mean that they're real players. Bots are actually not bad, at least in the category of them hitting their shots. They cannot build, but they do basically have aimbot to a certain extent. If you've ever been sprayed by, let's say, Midas, well, that's similar to a bot. Maybe not as good as Midas, but close. I would say it's similar to like a henchman from Chapter 2, Season 2. They're as good as them. They can be very good if they're locked onto you, but you can also destroy them pretty easily. And then guys, finally, why play bot lobbies? I would say it's for fun, to basically run the map for a few games without having to worry about sweats. For me, I use it for good XP, and obviously the XP grind this season, you have to use bot lobbies if you want the most, so I recommend it to anyone out there. And I would say if you're just starting out Fortnite and you want to learn the ropes, this is a great way to get a feel of the map with other players or other AIs being involved. I would say if you're a new player and you go into creative, yeah, you can learn how to build and you can learn how to shoot. But I feel like until you're in an actual game, you're not really going to understand Fortnite to its fullest extent. Well, guys, I hope this video helped you out. And honestly, I think bot lobbies are a ton of fun. I've never been banned for doing them. And I truly believe that they aren't against Epic's TOS. Just because I've never been banned and I made videos on them before, I think Epic Games knows players do them, and they could get rid of them if they wanted to. But I think at the end of the day, as long as you're not hurting anybody else, you're only hurting Fortnite creations, which maybe that's against your morals, and if it is, don't do it. But if you're not hurting anybody else, you're not affecting anybody else, then I really think there should be no problem with it. But thank you guys so much for watching. I really hope you guys did enjoy today's video. If you guys did, make sure to drop a sub. Go subscribe to my second channel. The link will be in the description. And also, guys, use my code COBESMIND. Thank you so much, guys. I'll see you later. Have a good one, guys. Bye.